School of Painting formed the spinal column of the various schools of Indian miniature art, which one of the following painting styles was not affected by Mughal paintings? Options: Pahadi, Rajasthani, Kangra, Kali Ghat or Kali Ghatta. So it's a difficult question for me. I'm more concerned with history, painting, architecture, all that. They are there in the book. We have to search. On searching, we got data that Mughal school, as we are saying, practically there was no Mughal school of art. See, they were nomads. They were settled in Central Asia. Properly speaking, if you look in the history portion, Genghis Khan or Genghis Khan from Mongolia emerged out with his massive, cruel army. He was following Tengri religion. He was challenging out Muslim world, and he destroyed variety of Muslim things in Arabia, particularly Central Asia also. He marched towards Russia, and huge and largest empire in those days was formed by this Genghis Khan, literally meaning of the name overlord of the world. After Genghis Khan, the Mongols spread in this all Central Asian territory, and then they carried out several attempts to get victory over India. You are aware that Kutluk Khwaja is the name of Mongol invader. He marched during rule of Alauddin Khilji, and he was able to reach till Delhi, where he was defeated. His 2 lakh Mongol army was defeated, either killed or converted to Islam by Alauddin Khilji, and established a separate place in Delhi for these converted Mughals. They were having very inferior position in the Delhi, though they were Muslims. They were forcefully converted to Islam by Alauddin Khilji, and then they settled over there. They are also Mughals. Initially, these Mughals were not following Islam, but one of the important personality in all these Mongol tribe, it is named as Temurlen, or in our language we are calling as Taimurlung. So Taimurlung or Temurlen embraced Islam at half of his life somewhere, and then Islam spreads in these Mongol people, where the Mongols were having inferior position. The name was not liked by Babur, Zahiruddin Al-Muhammad Babur, and so he used term Mughal instead of Mongol or Mughal. Like that term was introduced, and then he marched towards India. At last patch of his life, he was there in India. He was astonished by observing this all art and architecture in India. In our book only it is written. And then he sent these artists, architects and workers to Central Asia, Samarkand and all that territory, to carry out constructions like whatever present in India. And we are talking of Mughal style of art. Anyway, but whatever is given in our book, that we have to follow. And here I am saying the same thing, that there is Mughal style of art. And painting is backbone. So said, actually Islam is not allowing painting, especially human body and God, that is prohibited with my knowledge. I don't have that knowledge. But here we got the thing that Pahadi, Rajasthani and Kangra school of painting, they are emerged from Mughal school of painting. Why we are calling this Mughal school? The reason is that Akbar was able to establish a strong power in India. He was not, we can say, that rigid person. And therefore, he was patron of all these art, etc., etc. And therefore, these styles, the artists, they developed their styles in his court. We are calling that as Mughal style of painting. Yeah, in those days, these all people were gathered, you can say, in that territory of capital where he was. And when they developed this style, we are calling that as Mughal style here. So Mughal style of painting that we got from Pahadi, Rajasthani and Kangra. But Kalighata school of painting, that is indigenous one, and that was not affected by Mughal painting. That is the answer. According to Mimamsa system of philosophy, liberation is possible by means of option A, Jnana, B, Bhakti, C, Yoga and D, Karma. According to Mimamsa system of philosophy, there are different styles, or rather I should say different views, and in that Mimamsa is important view. According to that, liberation, that is we can call as salvation ultimate, or that is called as mukti. So this liberation or mukti, that is possible by means of. Now already there are totally four paths we are saying. These four paths are there for salvation, that is Jnana Marga, Bhakti Marga, Karma Marga and Yoga Marga. Out of that, the easiest one is given as Bhakti Marga, that is devotion, or we are saying that Bhakti movement was there. So that part we are considering as the easiest one path, whereas difficult most path was given as Jnana Marga. In between that, Karma Marga and Yoga Marga are there. Now particularly, if you look at Mimamsa philosophy, it is giving more stress on doctrine of action, that is Karma Siddhanta. So according to simple, in one line I can say that as we are carrying out your karma, that means work, whatever duties you are going to do, you are getting fruit accordingly. Well, that is not true. In this era or next era, I don't know. In this may be possible, in this birth or next birth, any way, say I am using word as era also. So this is the thing, that you are supposed to get fruit of that whatever you are doing. When, we don't know. That part we are calling as Karma Marga. Mimamsa.